Hi, this is Marcus. I'm going to do a very quick tutorial to show you the power of DxO Optics Pro 10. And DxO Optics Pro 10, it actually comes with, let me show you the couple applications that it actually comes with. Version 10 will have DxO Viewpoint 2 and DxO Film Pack 5 included, where you can actually be able to use these applications inside of DxO Pro. Each of these applications are sold separately, but if you buy them as a suite together, they'll work as a suite as well. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and take a photo here. Now this photo that you're looking at is extremely overexposed. If we look at with ISO we shot in 100 ISO with a 16 millimeter lens at f5 at a 1/320 shutter speed. Now you could go into the develop module and you could try to inside of Lightroom, if you went into the basics, and you could try to lower the exposure, which brings back a lot of the detail in there. So Lightroom does a very good job with that as well, but I'm going to show you how to really what we see is some barrel distortion, and Lightroom can't fix that the way the DxO can. So let me go ahead and take it back to what it is. Let's go ahead and go inside of DxO 10. Now when we're looking at this here, you can also look at the histogram. You can see where it's clipping at. You can see the clipping that's in it. But we're going to bring it in. What this did was DxO has a database of all the lenses for all the cameras, and every time a new camera and a new lens come out, it adds it to its database. So what this is going to allow me to do is download this information on this lens, and then it's going to go ahead and correct any barrel distortion or any distortion that's in that lens automatically. That's why it gives it such a this is such a powerful application. Now when we go into here, you can see the view pack is activated. ViewPack is activated and FilmPack is activated. And these applications will be accessible here. If I just scroll down and just show you the different areas, they will be, you know, that's Viewpoint and that's FilmPack. So everything is accessible within this one application. So what we're going to go ahead and do right now is go ahead and now if I can find a gray point like right here, I'm going to use a color picker and use this as my gray point. This is not a 18% neutral gray, but it's close enough, so I'm going to go ahead and click that, and that's going to set me, it's going to set my white balance a little bit cooler, so that's cool. So now what we're going to do is, now I can lower the exposure, so let's go ahead and lower the exposure in here. Okay, the exposure has been lowered, and then we're going to go do what we call smart lighting. This is a very effective feature that we have here called smart lighting. It knows how, and you can see all the hot spots that were in the face. It was just able to take that out. I'm going to increase the exposure just a little tad. Now you can see right now that looks pretty good. So we're going to go ahead and take this off. And now you're looking at the photo that's really coming in. Now we're going to select some tones. I'm going to look at some highlights and try to cool off some highlights. Bring them down. There's nothing really in the shadow that I want to bring up, but if I'm looking at the histogram, there's nothing really clipping. So I don't have to really bother the shadows, but I am going to bring up the midtones just a tad. That looks pretty good. Now this feature here called DxO Clear View, if this was a hazy day, you can see the effect that it would actually give you. It actually gives, and it actually makes the shirts wider. And I may use this. Let me just play around with the slider. Let's see what it gives me. It really does a good job. It makes the shirts wider, keeping the detail in the shirts. If I went up in here, you can see what it would actually do. It would just make it darker, kind of giving you what they call that HDR look. And you know what? Let me lower that down. We're going to go for that HDR look. That's pretty good right there. Skin tones, okay. And we're gonna go back to the exposure and just lighten it up just a tad. I don't want that dark. I'll take it back down just a tad. Okay, so now we're going to go down to contrast. I'm going to do the micro contrast. I'm going to take the fine contrast the opposite way. You can see what it's doing over here in this area here, really bringing it out. And I'm going to take the overall contrast up just a tad. Give it some good contrast. We're going into color, accentuation, and we're going to give it some vibrance. Not that much. Pop out the colors. I'm going to lower the saturation just a tad. I don't want the saturation to be that hot. And we're going to go into noise reduction. Now, this is where this application exceeds that. It's already shot at 100, so it's not going to have a lot of noise. If I go ahead and just put this on this person's face here, it's not a lot of noise, but we're going to turn it on anyway. And we're going to turn on Prime. And Prime is the new feature that they have for noise reduction that basically removes dead pixels and replaces them and gives you a noise-free document. So far everything looks good with what I've got right now. I can create a vignette, but I'm not going to do the vignette right now. I'm going to wait until I get into the other parts of the photo. That's my detail. Now the lens softening. This is pretty cool. This is where it comes in with the lens information. I'm going to click that. And I'm going to go ahead and give it some detail, overall detail. And I'm going to increase the bokeh. And do the global. I don't see any chromatic aberration, but we're going to turn it on anyway. Just if there's anything there, it'll go in there and get it. Dusting. Now this would be if I was trying to create, if I'm trying to correct some things. This almost works just like the healing tool inside of Lightroom, but I'm not going to use that. We don't need to do anything with the focal length. The focal length is fine. I don't need to change anything about that focal length. All that's good. That's viewpoint. I don't need to, there's nothing distorted for me to correct. Now we're in the film pack. In the film pack, we're going to go into a color negative film is what we're going to use. And what it does is now this is giving me that film look, and this is what I want to be able to do. But I want to go down and I want to choose, there's certain different film looks that you can use. Let me look at this one here. I really like this one. It's more of a 70s looking, especially if I lower the intensity of it. If I want to lower the intensity of it, I don't want to go with that film though. We're going to go with another film. We're going to go with this one here. I'm going to go with 100% with this film. We want to protect the saturated colors. We don't want them to get knocked out. We're going to scroll down. And we're going to go with a cooler look because it looks kind of warm. So I'm going to hit filter. It's going to give me a cooler tone. Now that's a very cool tone. And I'm going to lower the density of this. Lower the density about 40. I don't want it too cool, but I don't want it too hot as well. About right there. Really brought out the skies. Really looks pretty cool. Then I'm going to go into film grain because I want to add some grain to this. We're going to go with color negative film. And we're going to use a film that I'm using, that Fuji right here, or the Fuji 100. There we go. And what that's going to do is give some film grain to this. And if I started to look into this, when it comes up, there's a film grain that's being added to this. That's not noise, it's actually a film grain, and it actually looks pretty well. So if we go back to this and drop it back out, take it back out to that. There, that's fine. Film grain looks good. Now, when you start messing with the channels, if you know anything about the channels of, normally the red channels have some overall effects on the face. So if I do that, you'll start seeing the face. You know, so I'm taking a lot of that red out of the face is what I'm doing. I don't want them to be real, you know, that's about real good. And if I want to increase the greens, I can do this and you'll see those things that are green will start to come back out. The yellows, I'm going to increase that. in the blue, I'm going to go back and it really increase the blueness of the sky. Now you can see what it did to that photo. It really took it, gave it a dramatic look, but we're going to take the sky about right there. Really bring out some more of the sky. Okay, that's pretty good. And then what we're going to do, so if we just go ahead and compare what we started with, this is what we started with. This is what we have right now, right? Much better photo is what you're looking at right now. So let's take the compare off. Let's go back to the one here. And we're going to drop this down. And now we're going to do some vignetting. And vignetting is going to allow me to give some darkness around the sides. But I want to increase the midpoint. And I want to set that right here. And hit close. So that's my vignetting. Then I want to do, I don't need to do any blurring vignetting, because if you look at the bulk of this, this is really blurring out pretty well. Actually, some of the blurring is hitting this guy back here who is not the focus of the photo. So, but if I wanted to add some blurring vignetting, basically I just turn it on, set my point where I wanted to set it at. Let's see if I set it right here. And then I start to increase the intensity. You see what it's doing if I do that? Increase the radius, which works pretty well. We'll go ahead and close that. And then down here we got, if you wanted to put a frame on it, there's all type of frames that you could add, depending on your taste. Got dark room frames, black and white slide frames, but I don't want to add any frames to that. And take that back out. And then we're going to add textures. We'll go in here and do textures. You can see what that texture just did. It's a paper grain. It put some kind of, like, you know, grain over the, not a film grain, but noise grain. So I'm trying to give this a, depending on what type of look I'm trying to give this, I can use some type of overlay or some, not overlay, but some type of texture. If I was trying to give it, you know, some type of artistic view, some type of artistic look. But again, I don't want to add any texture, so I'm going to take that off. But I am going to add in what we call a light leak. And that light leak right here is showing at the bottom. Now, I can position this and put it anywhere I want to put it at the top. And it may actually work at the top coming through the clouds, like almost like a rainbow. But we're just going to look at it and see what we got here. And of course, that's at the bottom. There's different light leaks that you can use. That pretty much goes over the entire photo. And you can move the light leaks around as well. You have some in, you know, you can move them to different positions. But I'm looking at, and then there are some that are black and white. But I like the first one right there. And we're going to lower the intensity of that light leak. And we'll apply the toning. I'm going to increase it just a tad. And again, we're going to compare it. This is what we had before. This is what we got now. And I was able to, you know, to use it, to give this photo some film grain, which looks pretty well. So now if we go back and I'm going to send this to Lightroom, being it's from a raw file, I'm going to send it as a TIFF because it'll be non-compressed, and as a 16-bit. It's been exported back to Lightroom, and now you can see the file. So now if we go back into where this file is supposed to be, let's go back and go to library. Let's go back and hit demos. I'm going to look at this right here. So we'll put these photos side by side and compare them. And you can see the one we started with, an overblown out photo, to this one right here. And if we start zooming in, you can just see just the difference in the quality of the photo. This is very good. You can see here where the white shirt was blown out where you couldn't even see the detail. I was able to bring the detail of the shirt back without losing anything. You can see the grass was heavily blown out or too light, and you can see what I got here. And of course down there, that's my light leak that I put in there. And we can just keep moving over the photo and going up. and you can see just the difference in what it actually did for this. So again, if we go back to here, and I bring that photo up, and we're going to go fit. It's a very nice looking photo. It put the extension on there, DXO.TIFF. Let me know that it was done in DXO. Look at the histogram. The histogram is perfect. There's nothing blown out like it was before. Everything has been corrected, and it's just an overall good looking photo. So I just wanted to share that with you. So thanks for watching.